It's the talk of consumer electronics and gaming. Depending on who you ask, 3D could change the way we watch TV and play computer games. But there's one thing it seems everyone is agreed on. Who wants to wear those goofy glasses? It turns out you might not have to. At this week's Cebit IT Fair, developers are showing a new breed of screen that projects a 3D image directly at the viewer and doesn't require glasses.
In a year where all is about 3D and the craze, but everybody has to wear these shades, put on the shades, and you don't have to do that with our display.
Glasses are needed to separate the stereo image, one for the right eye and one for the left eye, but in the new displays that's done by a panel in front of the screen. The technology isn't new, but in the past has meant the image is sent to a single spot in space, and the viewer needs to be in that sweet spot to see the 3D image. Move to another position and all you see is a blurred image, or try to watch with a friend and someone's out of luck. But that's changing. Singapore's Sunny Ocean Studios has developed a panel that can be fitted to a standard display and sends out a stereo image to 64 positions.
We have a 64 view system. This means you have a very large area to view. You can run around and see a nice 3D display. Normally you have just few, 5 or 8 or 9 angles. Now we have 64 and it's very easy to catch a 3D effect.
Sunny Ocean hopes to sell the panels to display makers. Germany's Seafront has produced a display that projects to a single point, but one that moves with the viewer, so they always see a 3D image.
So basically we have a camera here as a part of the display, and the camera is looking at you, and what it does actually determines your position in space in terms of X, Y, Z coordinates, and this information is passed on to an algorithm running a computer in the background, and it's taken into account to give you the best 3D image to your very person, current person, so you can move around freely and still see a great 3D image.
The company recently demonstrated the technology in the US using the standard camera and a modified screen in this MacBook, and says it's received a lot of interest for the invention. But perhaps the most impressive system was this screen from Germany's Fraunhofer Institute.
In this case, we have an array of lenticulars, very narrow cylindrical lenslets, which divide the two images which are reproduced on a normal flat panel screen and direct these images directly onto the respective eye.
A pair of cameras watches the user and the screen is mechanically adjusted so that they always see a 3D image.
On top of the screen we have two cameras which detect the position of the viewer's eyes. And according to the position of the eyes, now the lenticular plate is moving in front of the flat panel screen, so the channels can follow the eyes of the user.
Additionally, infrared cameras above the screen watch out for hand gestures. Users can manipulate objects on screen and control software without actually touching the screen. The technologies are more complex than those coming to market this year, but judging from the reaction at Cebit, they're definitely worth keeping both eyes on. At Cebit 2010 in Hanover, Germany, this is Martin Williams, IDG News Service.